Welcome to RyGurkul.com. In this video, we'll talk about how to customize or change look and feel of Jira software on cloud version. Let's consider you're working on any company where company team requested to change this logo as well as this favicon. Other than that, they wanted to make the changes on look and feel like color, highlighter, everything they want to modify it. Instead of using default color codes, they wanted to change it to different one. And why it is required might be because of internal branding. Let's consider you are working within TCS, IBM, Apple. They are looking forward to modify these logos with their company logo. So how you'll do it? So I will explain you in detail how we can change on Jira Cloud version. To perform this activity, you need to have admin permissions and navigate it to the system settings. From system settings, just click on look and feel. It will navigate it to the page where it will give you options to change the logo. So this logo is this particular logo which you want to modify. If you want to modify the particular logo, here it is already provided the specifications of the logo. Based on the specifications, if you will upload it, it will look better. Now, if I wanted to change this logo, straight away I will upload any logo which I wanted to modify it. So as of now, I'm just uploading a random logo, but if you want, you can create your company logo and add it here, which looks much better because normally you're trying to do it for internal branding. Once you have uploaded the logo, click on upload logo. This will make the changes, and here you can see this logo has been updated successfully. So this is part of logo modifications. How we can modify this favicon icon? To modify the favicon icon, here we have the options available. Again, you can select any logo which is available on your screen. So this time I will use same thing. Upload it. Again, this will also have some specifications. Based on that, you can upload the images. Click on upload favicon. It will change the favicon icon as well. This is how we can modify it, and it is taking very quick response. Now, if you want to revert this logo to the original logo, just click on reset to default and it will be updated successfully. You can see this got updated. Similar way, you can also modify it the favicon icon as well. So both the logos are updated successfully now. Here you can also add the titles. So if you want to add some titles to show on the dashboard sidebar, you can add it. So general configurations, edit setting is the options where you can modify the title. Now here we also have some other settings, like if you want to modify the background color, you can just click on this pencil icon and select the color codes. You can also set it from here. So let's consider I wanted to update it the background color as green. We can have this effect available immediately. Similar way, if we want to update the highlighter with red color, we can also do it. Now this is updated successfully, and that's it. Here, whenever we'll click on projects, you can see this got updated successfully. This is the background color and this is the highlighter. You can see this highlighter. If I will click on teams, this will be highlighted. So this highlighter is updated successfully. Say this. This is the pink highlighter. Similar way, if you want to modify or make the changes or update it to default color, that is also possible to revert it back. Revert and then click on revert. Once you'll refresh, it will take impact on previous color codes or background color. Next, date and time formats. If you want to modify the date and time formats and wanted to keep as a hours, minutes and seconds, you can add it. Simply click on this pencil icon, add the details, and this will be modified successfully. Similar way, we can also add it the updated date format or complete date and time format. Everything can be modified according to us. If you wanted to use ISO 860 standards in Date Picker, you can also do it. Just click on this and update. This will be updated successfully. This is how you can change look and feel of Jira Cloud versions. And this impact is very quick. Whenever you are making the changes, make sure this is going to be impacted to your complete instance. So here you need to take a permissions, and once you have the proper permissions in place or permissions from your superiors, and once you will have the proper permissions from your superiors, you can happy to go ahead. Normally this requirement coming ahead directly from the superior itself, so this is easier for you to modify. If you don't have the permissions, don't try to modify it, otherwise you might get that might get escalated for you. So that's reason it's always better to first take a permissions and then only proceed it further. That's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.